Our next story is from Japan. Is the country finally changing? You see, Japan is a citadel of conservatives. Its government is mostly run by conservative older men. I'm not exaggerating. Most members of the Japanese parliament are aged 50 to 70. About 75% of them are males. But that may not be for long. Young people are stepping into office, and how? Japan's newest politicians are young, they are diverse, and they are asking the boomers and the millennials to move over. Meet Ryosuke Takashima. He is 26 years old. Only last year, he graduated from Harvard University, where he earned his degree in environmental engineering. And now he has made national history. He has become Japan's youngest ever mayor. Takashima secured more than 46% votes in the city of Ashiya. He defeated three rivals, including the incumbent mayor. And then there is a 26-year-old YouTuber named Shin. He also runs a Pokemon card store, but is best known for his YouTube videos. Shin is a single father. He has a 3-year-old son. He campaigned for the Hiratsuka City Council under the official name Shin the Hiratsuka YouTuber. And guess what? He won. And that's not all. Next we have Ayaka Nasuno. She is 25 years old. She was bullied as a child. She wanted to create her own community. And earlier this month, Nasuno bagged the highest number of votes for the Kawasaki City Council. And then there is 34-year-old Arfia Eri. Her parents are Uyghur and Uzbek. She studied at Georgetown University in the US, even worked for the United Nations. And now Eri has been elected to Japan's lower house. She is the first woman of Uyghur descent to be elected to not only Japanese, but any parliament in the world. You see, in a country like Japan that remains largely closed off to the world, that has extremely low levels of immigration, Eri is one of the few parliament members with non-Japanese ancestry. You see, Japan has an aging population. It has the world's second highest proportion of people aged 65 and over. Its politics is also dominated by old and incumbent men. In fact, data from Japan's Ministry of Internal Affairs and Communications showing that the ratio of re-elected incumbents has reached an astonishing 91%. In such a scenario, the likes of Takashima getting elected is unprecedented. And as I just told you, Japan is one of the world's most anti-immigration societies. For the longest time, it has kept its borders closed for foreign workers. Japanese immigration policy is infamous for its restrictions. Japan has a total population of 125 million. As of 2020, there were only 1.72 million foreign workers in the country. And this merely accounted for 2.5% of its working population. And it is despite Japan's crippling labor shortages. But as I said, Japan is changing its traditional ways. The country is trying to loosen its immigration policies. It is entering the global immigration war. Under a 2019 law, specified special skilled workers in 12 different sectors were granted Japanese visas. And this included nursing care, agriculture, construction, building, cleaning management, electronics and information, shipbuilding, automobile repair and maintenance, aviation, accommodation, fishery and aquaculture, food and beverage manufacturing, and other food services. But stays were limited to only 5 years, and that too without family members. But now Japan is trying to revise these very terms. It is going to expand the long-term work visas to multiple sectors. Workers would be allowed to renew their visas indefinitely and bring their family members with them. In February, Japan also announced that it will establish new and simplified immigration pathways. However, this is only for high-income earners and graduates of high-ranking foreign universities. Researchers, engineers, high-level managers would qualify for a visa, but they would need to have an annual income of at least $148,000 with a master's degree or more than 10 years of work experience. The government also saying it would be making it easier for the younger cohort to seek jobs in. I hope you realize that this is Japan we are talking about. A country that takes pride in its ethnic homogeneity, where immigration has long been considered taboo, which until last year was a pacifist country before it announced its defense overhaul, its biggest military buildup since the Second World War. And as China-Taiwan tensions escalated and Russia's invasion of Ukraine stoked warfares, Japan unveiled a $320 billion defense plan. It plans to buy missiles capable of striking China. It is preparing to sustain conflicts. You see, Japan is no more just defensive. It is no more opposed to immigration. And it is definitely no more governed by only old politicians. Japan is changing and it is ready to take on the new challenges. We are now available in your country. Download the app now. Get all the updates on the move.